can't fight them all.
But you have to. You're the Avatar.
I'm just one kid.
Aang is only 12 years old. It's really easy to forget while watching Avatar that Aang is just a kid. We see him defeating bad guys, taking out Fire Navy ships, acting really mature, and even learning from his mistakes. In real life, 12-year-olds go to school, they get in trouble by their teachers, they make stupid jokes, they come home, cause trouble. You know, just being a kid, right? So, because they're kids, you typically go easy on them for their bad behavior. Now, Aang is nothing like a typical 12-year-old. After Katara and Sokka saved him from the iceberg, and he found out there was a war, he immediately knew he had to fix this. It was his duty as the Avatar. Even if he tried to deny it for a bit, he still came to that conclusion. Now, because Aang has shown to be mature and to be able to handle responsibility well, people give him, I feel like, unfair criticism for a lot of his actions. One of the times where Aang was criticized the most was when Appa got stolen. We all know the story. Everybody was inside the library. Toph was outside watching Appa. The Sandbenders came. Toph couldn't do anything. She couldn't even see them. And the Sandbenders took Appa. Aang then blames Toph. Acts like Toph didn't help at all, acts like Toph just let them take Appa. He was basically acting like Toph had like normal eyes, that she could see them, that she had the ability to do anything, which she didn't. She didn't have the ability to go get them, she didn't have the ability to save Appa, she didn't even have the ability to fight. Aang even storms off and says, I'm gonna go find Appa by myself, and he takes the glider. Now, I really don't think that this was that bad. Now hear me out, Appa is not only Aang's pet slash guidance animal, Appa is also a lifetime friend. He is one of the only things in Aang's life that is from the Air Temple. Now keep in mind that the Air Temple that Aang grew up at, everything there was either burned, killed, or destroyed. The only parts that weren't destroyed were like the Avatar statues, and we all know why those weren't destroyed. That was pretty much just a plot device. Having all that in mind, plus the added fact that they had just figured out about the invasion plan, all the stress about having to master all four elements, defeating the Fire Lord before the comet arrives, and everything that's going through his mind, I think we can give Aang a pass on this one. Although I do not agree with how Aang handled it, I do think he handled it a lot better than any other 12-year-old would have handled it. Aang is the Avatar, but we do need to remember that he is just one kid.